everyone, myself Bhumi Patel, assistant professor at ALJ Institute of Engineering and Technology in the Department of Instrumentation and Control. Today's our topic is member seat function that is used in the different types of fuzzy logic application. So first of all, what is the member seat function? The member seat function is a function which represent the graph of the fuzzy set and allow user to quantify the elliptic term. That means we will discuss in the last session, we will divide the fuzzification and the defuzzification for this particular system. Crisp value or crisp input is applied to the fuzzification and then we can get the crisp output using the defuzzification. Generally aim when we use the fuzzy logic is there, whenever we find out the value between the true and false, that time we can use a fuzzy set. Now we have different types of fuzzy sets that we have to study in the last session, and we can get and we can derive the fuzzy union operation and fuzzy intersection operation. Now what is the member seat function? If they will given a different value for this particular system, so member seat function is represent a graph of this particular fuzzy set. So it is the graph which is used for mapping each element of the x to the value between 0 and 1. So this function is also known as the indicator of the characteristic function. Now how the member seat function is work? A member seat function for a fuzzy set A on the universal of the discourse x is defined as x tends to 0, 1, where each element of x is mapped to value between 0 and 1. So this value is called the membership value for this particular plant, or the degree of membership quantified the grade of the membership of the element in X to the fuzzy set F. Suppose the example is given, if we have to find out the temperature between 0 to 100, that time we can use the fuzzy set. Okay, but they will ask that you have to find the output between 40 to 50 degrees Celsius, then 50 to 60 degrees Celsius and 70 to 80 degrees Celsius. So in the same system or the same plant, they will give on a different fuzzy set. So for that, we can use for this particular value a member seat function. Okay, because if we have to find the value between 0 to 1, so we have to decide that 100 is my true value and the 0 is my false value. That means if the temperature will be reached 100, that time output goes on. But what about the value of 50, 60 and 80? So for that, we have to use a member seat function. So the member seat function allows us to graphically represent of the fuzzy set. Up to now, we will define the fuzzy set in the equation form. Suppose set is given as 0, 1, set B is given in the form of 2, 3, and then we have to find the fuzzy set for the union operation or the intersection operation. But using the member seat function, they will give the graph of the representation of the fuzzy set. So we can easily identify the output of this particular system. So the x-axis represent the universal of the discourse, where y-axis represent the degree of the membership in the 0-1 interval. Okay, so the first membership function that is used in the fuzzy logic, that is the triangle function. It is defined by a lower limit A, an upper limit B, and a value M, where A less than M less than B. Okay, so what is the actual graph of the triangle function of the member seat function? So here, the value of the x-axis is given limit A, that is my lower limit, limit B, that is my upper limit, and M, a value where the A less than M, M less than B. Suppose they will ask to find the age between the person or all the person between the age 50 to 70. So 50 is indicate my lower limit, 70 is indicate my upper limit, and we have to find the value of f. Okay, so this is my triangle function. So how we have to find the value of f? So for that we have different possibility in the triangle function. It is 0 if x less than equal to a. If the value is less than equal to 50, so we can get the 0. If the x is between a and m, so the equation is x minus a, m minus a. So we have to find the value of x minus a and m minus a. So this is second possibility. If the value is between m and b, that means lower upper limit and the m. So the equation will become b minus x upon b minus m. And if the value is greater than equal to b, that means above the upper limit, we can get the 0. So what is the actual meaning of the triangle function? If we have to decide the lower limit and we have to decide the higher limit or the upper limit. If my value is lower than the lower limit, we can get the 0 output. If my value is higher than the higher limit, we can get the 0 output. But if my value is between lower limit and the upper limit, that time we have to apply these two formula. If the value is between a and m, we can apply x minus a upon m minus m a. And if the value between m and b, that time we have to apply b minus x upon b minus m. Clear? Now next one, membership function is trapezoid function. It defines by the lower limit a and upper limit d, a lower support limit b and a upper support limit c, where a less than b less than c less than d. So what is the actual graph of the trapezoid function? So it is look like that, where a is my lower limit and d is my upper limit. What is the b? It is the lower support limit b, and the c is the upper support limit c. So what is the actual equation for this trapezoid function? If my value is less than a or greater than d, as you know, if it is less than a or greater than d, we can get the output 0. If it's between a and b, that means lower limit and lower support limit b, that means the equation is x minus a, b minus a. The value is between a less than equal to x less than equal to b. If the value is between the two support limit, that means lower support limit b and upper support limit c, so we can get the answer 1, because here you can see that in this graph in the form of trapezoid, so we can get the value 1 when the value is between the lower support limit b and upper support limit c. And if my value is between c and d, that means c less than equal to x less than equal to d, so we can get the value using this equation, d minus x upon d minus c. Okay, so depending upon the system equation, we have to define the membership function. The next one is the Gaussian function. It is defined by the central value m and a standard derivation k greater than 0. The smallest k is, the narrow the bell is. That means this is the actual graph of the Gaussian function. Now what is the equation of the Gaussian function? So here you cannot define the upper limit or the lower limit or the upper limb limit or the lower limb limit. So the equation is mu ax, that is equal to e raised to minus x minus m whole square upon 2k square. So Gaussian function is generally depend the value of m and the value of k. If we change the value of k, we can get the different membership function. Okay, so this is all about the membership function. We have generally three types of membership function: triangle function, trapezoid function and the Gaussian function. Okay, so depending upon the plant requirement, we have to use this type of member sec function to find out the value between the true and false condition. Now, next one is the classical set theory versus the fuzzy set theory. Which one is better for the which application? So, first is classical set theory is a class of the theory set having the sharp boundary. Okay, and the fuzzy set theory is the class of those set having the unsafe boundary. So we can decide the boundary using the classical set theory. Now the classical set theory is defined by the exact boundary only 0 and 1. And in the fuzzy set theory is defined by the boundary between 0 and 1. Okay, now the classical set theory, there is no uncertainty about the boundary location of the set because we have clear about the boundary, it is 0 or the 1. And in the fuzzy set theory, it always exists the uncertainty about the boundary location of the set because if the crisp input value is changed, the boundary location will be changed. And the classical set theory is widely used in the design of digital system, and the fuzzy set theory is mainly used in the fuzzy controller because in the classical set we deal with only true or false condition. So the main application of the classical set theory is the digital system, and the fuzzy set theory is used in the fuzzy controller because we know about the value between the 0 and 1 condition. Next one is the different application where the fuzzy logic is used. So we can use in the microwave oven to set the temperature. We can use the industry of the chemicals for controlling the pH and the chemical distillation process. Then the industry of the manufacturing for the optimization of milk and cheese production, vacuum cleaner and the timing of the washing machine. So where the timing consider is there, if we can set the timing for this particular system, that time we can use the fuzzy logic theory. Also we have to use in the heaters, washing machine, okay, air conditioners. So these are the application that we have to use the fuzzy logic system. Now what is the advantages of the fuzzy logic? So any user can easily understand the structure of the fuzzy logic because the block diagram and architecture of the fuzzy logic is very simple. This concept is based on the set theory of the mathematics. So that's why it is very simple because we have easily understand the concept of the fuzzy logic theory. It allows the user for controlling the control machine and consumer product, and the development time of the fuzzy logic is short as compared to the conventional method. So this is the advantages of the fuzzy logic. Now what are the disadvantages of the fuzzy logic? So the run time of the fuzzy logic system is slow and it takes a long time to produce the output because whatever input is given, it goes through the fuzzification process, then it goes through the defuzzification process. So run time of the fuzzy logic system is slow compared to the other system. Fuzzy logic are not suitable for those problems that require a very high accuracy. And the system of the fuzzy logic need a lot of testing for verification and validation because we have to find the value between the true and false condition. So we need so many times of testing for this particular one system. Then we have to need validation process and put in the verification process. Thank you everyone. If anyone have doubt, then contact me in my email ID.